Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Queue Silliness on the channel. Today, we are going to be playing as Stitches after a long, 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 long time of him not being on the channel. I believe this is actually day 500, and I'm not joking. Because the last time that I played Stitches for Solo Queue Silliness was on February 23rd of 2016. And at the time of this recording, I already did the math because we were waiting in queue forever. It's 499 days today, meaning that when this video comes out, it's actually going to be 500 days since the last time I played Stitches. So on our team today, it's going to be Li Ming, Kerrigan, Illidan, Kael'thas, and Stitches. Literally four assassins and a warrior going up against Malthael, Tyrio, Chromie, Nova, and Zul. Four assassins and a warrior. Hooray. Level 1 going to be going for Heavy Slam. The build I'm going to be doing today is going to be heavier emphasis on damage and less emphasis on survivability, which may seem a bad idea, excuse me. But one thing I will say is that it does a pretty impressive amount of damage if you're able to stay alive. It's going to heavily, heavily emphasize on making sure that you're getting maximum amount of area covered with your slams. And on top of that, it's not going to be really all that... you don't have to really worry too much about landing your hooks. I mean, landing hooks is important, of course. I was able to land that on Chromie, and she's gone. All right. Or at least we were able to get a kill here. Now, there is another build that you could do for Stitches, which is actually not that bad. And that is the solo survivability build that you can do that is basically heavily emphasis on the HP regen and increasing the amount of health that Stitches has. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to save. I mean, I tried saving Kerrigan there, but that just wasn't in the cards, I guess. Now, we are going to be on Hanamiru, which, of course, is everyone in the world's favorite map of all time. And it's not really a good Stitches map, going to be honest. I'm not exactly sure what heroes actually really do thrive in or on Hanamiru. See if I can help out Kael'thas. I don't know why Kael'thas decided to come back. That was not the real Nova there. Every time Stitches uses Slam, this is going to basically do, well, after level 4, it's going to start inflicting damage over time, which is very, very nice. And again, the amount of damage that you can get out of Stitches is actually really impressive. Not the real Nova there. Now, because we are going up against a Nova, I am very, very curious to see how well I can keep her out of stealth, or how long I can keep her out of stealth. There's a time trap by Chromie. Again, with how tanky Stitches is, I don't know what that slam was. Stitches can take he can take quite a beating, which is what I like about him. The brawler build that you can do is actually quite nice, but again, that's a little bit more. That's if you absolutely just need heals, or you're going up against like a really brawly team, like a bunch of warriors or something like that. I wouldn't necessarily say it's the best against four assassins, just because of how much damage you're going to be taking. One day I'll land a hook, I promise. Here we go. Are we going to defend or are we going to go on offense? I think right now, probably the best option for me is just to go on offense because I do not have a whole lot of mana right now. I want to get this movement. So level 4 here, going to be going for Putrid Ground, which is going to be the talent that I was talking about earlier, which basically infects any and all targets that I hit with Slam with a damage over time or a dot. Now, what's nice about that is that this is going to be something that I can start building on, and it really provides a nice little foundation of how much damage over time the Stitches can do. Again, it's pretty impressive how much... I've seen much better Stitches players than I do this build, and it's awesome. I'm not going to say that I'm going to show you the best example of that right now. However, I will say that you should try it if you really don't like playing the brawly type. Apparently Nova is here somewhere. There she is, right there. Well, Illidan's going to stay on top of Nova here, and I don't have a hook for him. We did get the payload done. Let's see if I can back away from everyone here. Basically get body blocked to oblivion. Do not have Gorge up quite yet, or Devour. It was just coming up there right at the end, but those body blocks, man... So, after 4 minutes, it's 7-3. It's pretty good. We've taken a lot of damage so far. This is what a warrior is supposed to do. Darkshire, I hunger. I think Stitches just said Darkshire, I hunger. I kind of like that. I'm gonna come down here and start moving the payload. The enemy team's payload, of course, is gonna be spawning a little bit sooner. Hopefully it's gonna... I mean, I really hope that it's not gonna be just me moving this. Now, we do have a good potential here for a lot of really awesome teamfighting abilities, or teamfight scenarios with Slam. Because it's going to be such close quarter combat. I actually didn't know that there was a piece of creep there. Zool wants to go one-on-one with Stitches. I'm not sure if that's a wise idea, Zool. Choose a talent. So level 7 going to be going for Toxic Gas, which is going to increase the amount of damage and the area of effect of my passive, which is extremely important when I'm going for the damage over time. So I was able to land right there on Zool, but I don't know what happened to Devour there. Devour did just straight up just didn't do anything. Gonna back away from Chrome here because you know she's gonna be trying to snipe. Here comes Kerrigan. I honestly don't know where Illidan is right now, but apparently we're not gonna be able to get this one down. Alright! Well, it's a little bit too late now to ask for assistance, Kerrigan. I guess Mildon went to go tap the fountain. Li Ming was up top, and I think Kel'Thas was dead. So, yeah, this is going pretty good. Pretty good for a solo queue silliness. It's very solo queue-y. Kel'Thas going to walk forward and die again. It's pretty good. And after 6 minutes, it's 11-4. Very good. So I think now is a good time, especially being on Hanamura, which is everyone's favorite map ever. We gotta look for the finer things. We gotta look for the solo queue things. What are the finer points in life that we wanna harp on? I think for starters, we have landed a payload. We've done damage to the enemy team's core, which is pretty good. That's not asking for a lot. That's again, you're talking about baby steps here. Apparently that didn't hit Tyrio. I don't know how that hook didn't land on anything. Decent damage there by Kel'Thas. They're able to land the slam on Zool. Oh man, Tyrio had like the picture-perfect like block there for Chromie. That's about the only place that he could have gone that would have saved her. You see the damage over time effect that I'm talking about, though. Illidan's gonna overextend way too much and get killed by the by a Malphail. Kerrigan is up top. I was able to get the Devour there on a creep. But I'm going to just get poisoned by, I guess it was Poison Nova. Your spirit will find its way back soon. How's Kerrigan doing up there? Alright, we got a turret. So the enemy team is going to get another payload shot here very soon. 15-4. Not too bad. Kel'Thas died 5 times. I've died 3 times. Kerrigan on her solo mission is going to get swarmed upon by Zool and Nova, and she got her. Good job. Way to go. Level 10 going to be going for Putrid Bile. Putrid Bile, of course, sort of playing into the whole mentality of you're just going to be doing damage over time and zoning out the enemy team. Going to go right for Malphail here, although I really need Li Ming to continue to fight. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Sindicta, you killed Kel'Thas there. Well, here's the thing. He was dead anyway. If you saw his HP, and look what the Reaper's Mark was doing to him. He was already dead, and I was hoping to get a kill. Unfortunately, though, Li Ming was not, I guess, in position to make any attacks. Which is just how we like it. 18-5 right now. Doing pretty good. Enemy team up by 2 HP. All right. How's our Kel'Thas player doing? He's doing. How about Illidan? Illidan, you doing, Illidan? Yeah, he's doing. Alright. Welcome to my wonderful world of solo queue. I'll be your host, Invicta. Tried to block the shot for you. I really did. There's a judgment there by Tyrio. Unfortunately, I was not able to get her with the Devour, or not the Devour, but the Slam somehow. I go. See the amount of damage I'm able to do there with the slam. Li Ming going after Chromie here. And there's the hunt by Tyrael. By Tyrael, I mean Illidan. Hey! Time trap, alright. Alright, so we're able to get a couple kills. Pretty good. I'm inexplicably number one on hero damage. Don't ask me how I did that. I'm gonna go help out Kerrigan up top here. And no, actually, I thought that Kerrigan was going after the, was moving the payload. Apparently not. She was able to get the kill there on Zul, so, alright. Again, you gotta look for the smaller things in Heroes of the Storm. Not always about winning. Not always about losing. It's not even always about having fun. It's always making sure you're meeting some sort of goal. Our goal has already been met. I'm happy that we even got one shot. Hey, look at this. We're gonna be doing two shots here. Who would have thought? Look at that. We've doubled our goal. It's that simple. If you set your expectations low, you never know what kind of heights you're going to reach. There we go. Landing hooks, getting kills. Illidan's dead again. Doing great. Kerrigan's going to stay on her solo mission up top. We have our other payload down here. I'm going to be looking to try to get Malthael with a hook. Tyrael trying to position himself in between myself and Malthael. I'm going to land the slam there and let Malthael just sort of flounder in it, or not. Was not able to get the slam off. We were able to kill Malthael, though. I'm not sure why Li Ming and Kael'thas backed off so much. I feel like we could have actually gotten a kill on Tyrael as well. There we go, able to take down Nova. Kael'thas trying to run away. There's a healing pole sitting right there, but no one's going to grab it. Woo! Alright, 12-24, we're doing great, team. Only down by 1 HP on the core. Illidan's contemplating his next strategy. I really wish Kerrigan would come down here to come escort the payload. She's just gonna stay up there soaking XP. Saw the angle I was trying to go there on Chromie. Look at the damage over time, though, that I'm able to do with just slam alone. Now imagine all that damage along with the damage of Putrid Bile, and you've got yourself a recipe of a pretty impressive amount of damage. Kerrigan going to try to defend against the enemy team there. Oh, just out of range. I don't have Fishing Hook quite yet. I'll be getting it soon, though. Oh, you got to get out of the way, Li Ming. Li Ming and I butting heads there on the, Nope. Gonna slow the, there's the Pyroblast there on Tyrael. He should be dead. There we go. Alright, good job. Alright, woo! We got there. Level 16, gonna be going for Pulverize. I'm not actually gonna go for Fishing Hook because I have not been able to land it at all today. And it's the first time that we're able to get the, not exactly sure why we need the recon camp, Kael'thas, but okay. This is the first time that we're actually going to be able to get a solid team fight in our favor. And we need somebody to come down here and help out. I do see that Aldale's right there. So there's the hunt by Illidan. Add the slow again, and then we're still trying to get around the freaking payload. We're able to do it. Down goes Malthael. I'm gonna use the scouting there by from the camp. See if I can get Chromie as well. Able to take down Nova. Tyrael using judgment there on Li Ming. I think we're gonna be able to get Zul. I really wish this Li Ming would stop running into me. Able to take down Chromie, but she's not going to be able to take down Tyrael. Alright, so it's a 4-for-1. Tyrael lives 31-20. Everyone dying a whole lot. And Tyrael's gonna get an easy peasy solo cap. Actually, no, he's gonna try to take down the fort, which I guess is a decent idea. Except he doesn't have any creep support. So if Tyrael takes his fort down, the next one's is basically going to shoot times two, and Nova actually using precision strike, so there you go. So we're gonna be down to 1 HP on our core. And Team Solo Q mid silliness blah blah blah, blah, blah is going well. It's going as well as you would expect on Hanamura. Team getting another one there. There's Chromie. I'm going to be going after Chromie here. Completely whipped on the slam there. Able to take down Chromie. Down she goes. Going to use slam to slow down Nova as well, then activate Putrid Bile. That slowing field not the slowing field, but the sanctification that Tyrael has wreaking havoc with the accuracy. Me being able to zone, we are able to take him down. Tyrael killed Kerrigan. Oh, I love that. I love that. There we go. So we're able to take down all five. And we're going to get two shots off on the core. And we're going to go after the boss here. So if we can make this work, then let it be known that Team Solo Q, Mid Silliness 9, LMQ, Copenhagen Wolves, those of us have your way, Toasty Quiznos, Subway, FBI Investigation Station, the greatest team of all time, you know it. You know it. So, I'm pretty sure this is only going to be one shot. Able to take him down, down he goes. So it's down to 1 HP here, and all we got to do is get our, all we have to do is just get our payload in, and that's it. I'm going to start moving this one right away here. Level 20, by the way, I'm going to be going for the Potent Bile, which is going to add a slow and also lasts a lot longer. The enemy team is not on their payload. They're just now getting on their payload right now. I don't know why we're not taking this here. All three of us need to be... We need at least three people here. It's going to come down to the... it's going to come down to the team fight. Kael'thas using the recon... Recon scout there. Down goes the enemy team. Here comes Tyrael using judgment on me. The enemy team's their payload's not quite there yet. No one actually is escorting it. Tyrael wanted to brawl with me. I don't know why you would do that. And I'm gonna be able to walk it in for the win. Oh, Solo Q silliness. Happy 500 days, Stitches. Final total 28-35. I'm not even going to bother linking the build in. Actually, I'm just kidding. I'll link it down there. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, stay around for more of the silliness of the solo queue. Until then, so long, everybody. LOL.